guys, warm welcome you all. In today's video, we are going to discuss important MCQs on Renesha. Yes, friends, आज हम Renesha period से related important MCQs discuss करने वाले हैं इस important video में. And ये video बहुत ही ज़्यादा important है आपके exam point of view से. If you are going for TCET, PCET level exams of English literature, even for state level exams or central level exams, all the questions are included in this video. They are asked in previous year exams of English literature. Without any delay, move on to the topic. And please, friends, note down all the questions with its answer in your notebook. Let's start the video. The very first question here we have: what country is considered to be the birthplace of the Renesha? Yes, friends, we have the question number one of the video, and here we have the option A, B, C, D. And which country is considered to be the birthplace of the Renesha? You have to tell the answer. And A, B, C, Italy, Spain, France, or England. The correct answer of this question is option A. Italy is considered to be the birthplace of the Renesha during the time period of the 14th century. 14th century में इटली में Renesha का start हुआ था, Renesha begin हुआ था, इसका birth place इटली है, ये ऐसा समझा जाता है, ऐसा English literature में लिखा गया है. And it is thought to be considered that Italy in the 14th century was the place where Renesha happened first time. Second, we have the question number two. Which of the following was the result of John Gutenberg's printing press? We have the option here A, B, C, D. A option, an increase in the use of Latin. B option, we have the writing of the books in vernacular. Third option, we have an abandonment of the movable type technology. D option, we have the spreading of the newly written words of the Magna Carta. So which one is the correct option we have here out of these four options? So the answer is option B is the correct answer. The writing of the books in vernacular is the considered to be the result of the Johann Gutenberg's printing press. And Johann Gutenberg was the person who is thought or who is believed to be the who was the person who invented, who first time used the movable printing press. Next question we have, question number third. Which of the books describes Renesha court life and behavior? We have the option A, B we have the option Castiglione, the courtier, B we have the Machiavelli's the prince, Augustine's City of God, or Boccaccio's Decameron. These all are the books of the great Renesha writers and Renesha thinkers they we have here. And which book describes Renesha court life and behavior? कौन सी book Renesha के court life, पुनर्जागरण time के court life और behavior को दर्शाता है, उसमें description आपको मिलता है. Out of these four options, which one is the correct? And the correct answer we have option A. Yes, friends, option A is the correct answer. Castiglione, the court. The courtier is the answer of this question. Moving on to the question number fourth. Number fourth, we have, why did the Renesha begin in Italy? This is the question, and we have the option here. Renesha Italy में क्यों begin हुआ? इसका reason जानना है. इस question का answer इस options में से आपको ढूंढना है. A option we have, trade happened because Italy is on the Mediterranean Sea, which supported the Renesha. Second option we have, the church was centered in Italy and helped organize Renesha ideas. Third we have, Italy had trade which caused more religious ideas to spread. And D option we have, Italian artists traveled and spoke all through Europe, spreading their new ideas. Out of these four options, which is correct according to the questions of this, why did Renesha begin in Italy? So the answer of this question we have here in out of these four options, option A. Option A is the correct answer. Trade happened because Italy is on the Mediterranean Sea which supported the Renaissance. Because Italy में सबसे पहले Renaissance start हुआ 14th century में, and जो की trade हुआ Mediterranean Sea Italy के वहाँ था, Italy में था, and that's why उसने Renaissance को support किया था. Italy ने, Italy में सबसे पहले begin हुआ, and trade happened at that time of the Renaissance when it was begin in Italy in the 14th century, and that's why it spreaded to the Renaissance and supported the ideology of the Renaissance in Italy. Next question we have, question number 5, who created the famous work in the praise of folly, in praise of folly that mocked certain church practices? A, we have option Dante Menentis, we have De Erasmus, and C, we have Cosimo De Erasmus, D, we have Donatello. Out of these four options, who is the created, who was the person, who was the writer, who was the thinker who created the famous work in praise of folly that mocked certain church practices? Means what about the rule regulations were going on in the church, and what practices had been followed by the church in the time of the 14th century, that all was described or were written in the work in praise of folly, and who had written this work? You have to tell the answer of this question, and option B is the correct answer. Yes friends, option B is the correct answer. Desiderius Erasmus is the correct answer of this question. Number 6 question we have, and the question number 6 is, a basic idea contains in the Sir Thomas More's Utopia was, we have the option here A, B, C, D. A is evil exist because men and women are basically corrupt. B option we have, political leaders must learn how to manipulate their subjects. Option C we have, social order is only an unattainable ideal. And D option we have, corruption and war are due to acquisitiveness of and private property. These are out of these four options, which is related to the Thomas More's Utopia. The answer we have here, option D. Option D is the correct answer regarding this question. Corruption and war are due to the acquisitiveness and private property. This is the option, and Thomas More's Utopia that was written in 1516, and Utopia is related to in an imaginary place which is considered to be ideal. Jo bahut hi imaginary place hai, but wo bahut hi ideal, where there is no kind of corruption, everyone has equal rights. And Sir Thomas More had written this work in 1516. And this work is related to the one of the important work written during the time of Renaissance. And next question we have, question number 7. As we know that the word Renaissance means rebirth, but from what language it is translated? Yes friends, the option we have A, B, C and D. Out of these four options, you must have the answer of this question. So the correct answer is option B, French. This is translated from the French language Renaissance, which means rebirth, and it was a language French which was translated into English as rebirth. Next question number 8 we have, which of these is not a Renaissance artist, architect or writer? A, Leonardo da Vinci. We have Raphael, second option. C, we have Lorenzo di Medic, and D, we have Michelangelo. Out of these four options, who was not considered, who was not the Renaissance artist and even architect and writer? We all know this question. You must have given the answer of this question right correctly. And option C, yes friends, Lorenzo di Medic was not the Renaissance artist. All other Leonardo da Vinci, Raphael and Michelangelo, these all are great painters of the Renaissance time, and they have written, they have painted Renaissance very beautifully in their paintings. Next question we have, question number nine question we have, which was a major characteristic of the Renaissance? We have the option here, A, B, C, and D. Conformity, B option, mysticism, C option, humanism, or D option, we have obedience. Out of these four options, which is the major characteristic, one of the important characteristic of the Renaissance? And the correct answer is option C. Humanism is the right answer of this question, and this is one of the important characteristic we have here. And what is humanism? Humanism kya hai? Humanism is related to the values of human beings. Yes, because before this, Christianity or church or religion was above all. There was no importance of human beings before the religion or in front of religion or Christianity or church. But when Renaissance came in the world, or in first time in Italy, and after that in rest of the countries of the Europe, then humanism or human beings was the prominent given to the prominent place, and they were regarded as the valued, which are good and which are considered to be the best for the human beings. They had respected, they had given a kind of theory, a kind of things that is related to the values of human being. This is called humanism in the Renaissance time. Next question number 10 we have, what was the period of the time in Europe called that happened before the Renaissance? What was the time? Yahan pe pucha ja raha hai ki Renaissance ke Europe mein what time kaun sa tha jo Renaissance ke aane se pehle ka time. What was the period known as in a history of English literature before Renaissance happened? We have the option A, Golden Ages. That was B, we have the Age of Glory. C, we have the Middle Ages. And D, we have the Gray Years. Out of these four options, which is the correct answer? And we have the answer is option C. The Middle Ages was the period that was happened in Europe before Renaissance, because it was the time of the 1000 AD to 15th century. Next question we have, question number 11. How was humanism different from the way most people thought before the Renaissance? Option A, we have, it thought that life could be nice. It thought that life did not have to be all work. It said that human could enjoy comfort. And D option, we have all the above. So the question is, how was humanism different from the way most people thought before Renaissance? Kis tarike se log sochte the Renaissance ka pehle jo time tha? Humanism was different from the way most people thought before Renaissance. Kis tarike se wo Renaissance ke time pe wo difference ho gaya? What was humanism during the time of Renaissance? So out of these four options, the correct answer we have here option D. It thought that life could be nice. Yes, Renaissance ke time mein ye samjha jane laga tha ki life achhi hoti hai, because there was no interference of the religion, church and pope all. It was said that life did not have to be all work, and it said that human could enjoy comfort. These all are the options which are correct according to the humanism during the time of the Renaissance, and it was different from what humanism was considered before the Renaissance time. Now moving on to the question number 12. Number 12 question we have, from what ancient civilization did the people in Italy to get the idea for humanism? Option A, we have the Romans and Greek. Option B, we have the Greeks and Egyptian. Option C, we have Egyptians and the Chinese. And D, we have the Chinese and the Persians. And from what ancient civilization? यहाँ पे question में पूछा जा रहा है कि किस ancient civilization से, सभ्यता से Italy ने ये humanism का idea adopt किया, या कहाँ से उनको ये idea मिला humanism का? कौन सी वो civilization थी, कौन सी ancient सभ्यता थी जिससे उन्होंने को ये idea मिला है humanism का? So the answer we have the here, out of these four options? Option A is the correct answer. From the Romans and the Greeks, they have got the idea of humanism for Renaissance. Next question, number 13, we have, what artist is considered the first Renaissance painter? We have the option A, B, C, and D. Out of these four options, which one is the correct answer? And the correct answer is Giotto. Giotto was the first Renaissance, is considered artist who was considered to be the first Renaissance painter. Number 14 question we have, what made Renaissance painting different from the previous period of art? Option A, we have, it was a very abstract. Second, we have option B, subjects were painted as they appeared in nature. C, we have, emphasis was on symbolism, not realism. And option D, we have all the above. यहाँ पे क्वेश्चन में पूछा गया रहा है, बिकॉज पेंटिंग वॉज, इटालियन पेंटर्स वर द इम्पॉर्टेंट मैन हु कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड अलॉट टू रेनेशा, इटालियन रेनेशा, एंड दैट वॉज द क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू हिम, रिलेटेड टू देम. वॉट मेड रेनेशा पेंटिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस पीरियड ऑफ आर्ट? रेनेशा पेंटिंग ने किस तरीके से अपने आप को डिफर किया, अपने आप को अलग रखा फ्रॉम प्रीवियस आर्ट, जो प्रीवियस पीरियड्स के आर्ट हुआ करते थे, कल्चर हुआ करते थे, उसको अब रेनेशा पेंटर्स ने, रेनेशा पेंटिंग ने अपने आप को अलग कैसे रखा? मीन व्हाट वाज यूनिक इन द पेंटिंग्स ऑफ द रेनेशा पेंटर्स? सो आउट ऑफ दीज फोर ऑप्शन वी हैव द करेक्ट आंसर ऑप्शन बी, सब्जेक्ट पेंटेड एज दे अपीयर्ड इन नेचर. दिस इज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस क्वेश्चन. प्लीज़ फ्रेंड्स, आपको क्वेश्चंस अच्छे लग रहे हैं, प्लीज़ लाइक करिए वीडियो को, एंड ऑल्सो साथ ही साथ आप नोट डाउन करते चले जाओ इन क्वेश्चंस के आंसर्स को, बिकॉज दीज ऑल आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू द रेनेशा पीरियड. नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 ऑफ द वीडियो. क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 वी हैव हियर, अराउंड व्हाट ईयर डिड द रेनेशा बिगिन? वी हैव द ऑप्शन ए, बी, सी, एंड डी. आउट ऑफ दीज फोर ऑप्शंस, the option C is the correct answer. Around 1400 or in the late 14th century, it was begin in Italy. Number 16, we have, Renaissance humanism represented. Option A, we have, those who wanted to separate church and state. B, we have, a celebration of human subject. C, we have, related to the question, a rejection of God and refocus on humanity. And D, we have, a late medieval atheist movement. This was the option we have. And out of these four options, which is the correct related to the Renaissance humanism? So the option C is the correct answer, a rejection of God and refocus on humanity. This was the Renaissance humanism presented. Because before this, in Greek and Roman culture, Roman civilization, you will see that there was the superiority of humanity. There was given a value to humans. But in Europe, or you will see in the rest part of the world, God, religion, church, Pope was above all. But here in Renaissance period, humanism was given importance, given value, and rejection of God and refocus on humanity was the humanism that was represented in Renaissance time. Number 17 question we have, and this is the last question of this video, who invented movable printing press? Yes friends, this is very important question. And out of these four options, option D, John Gutenberg was the person who invented movable type printing press, and William Caxton was the person who introduced प्रिंटिंग प्रेस इन इंग्लैंड. विलियम कैंगस्टन ने इंग्लैंड में इंट्रोड्यूस किया था प्रिंटिंग प्रेस को, एंड दिस वॉज द पर्सन जॉन गुटेनबर्ग हु इन्वेंटेड मूवेबल टाइप प्रिंटिंग प्रेस इन रेनेशा टाइम. एंड सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस वॉज ऑल इन टूडेज वीडियो. वी हैड डिस्कस इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू रेनेशा टाइम, एंड इन कमिंग वीडियोज यू विल गेट मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट MCQs ऑन डिफरेंट राइटर्स, पोएट्स, एंड ऑल्सो ऑफ द पीरियड्स. एंड प्लीज चेक आउट द प्लेलिस्ट here on this channel. Englert Zone, you will get more important MCQs related videos here in on this channel, Englert Zone. Please check out the playlist button. And thank you very much for watching this.